can the Walworth eye blood pressure measurement be accurate? Is it actually a product from Walmart? The great achiever of the ability to spike in this video, we will use frequency-determined error and mutual matrix to quantify the blood pressure of the Walworth eye, heart rate, blood pressure, and smooth analysis capabilities to publish this kind of video ranking website, regardless of whether a mimeprogram is used to display this data, and also comprehensively evaluate the performance of the Walworth eye in multiple dimensions, such as material, screen, and configuration. To comprehensively evaluate the performance of the Walworth eye here is the communication component Walworth eye quantitative review video. The distinctive feature of the Walworth eye is dynamic blood pressure measurement compared to traditional blood pressure monitors. It can measure anytime, anywhere, and it can also measure automatically while sleeping at night, the common electronic blood pressure monitors we see. All measure using the oscillometric method. The principle is first inflate the cuff to block arterial blood flow, then gradually release it. During the release process, the gas pressure inside the air bladder is detected by a pressure sensor and the faint pulse waves are extracted. Each time the heart contracts, it will forcefully pump blood into the arteries. The blood pressure at this time is the systolic pressure. Also called high pressure, when a person's heart relaxes, the arterial blood vessels elastically recoil. The blood pressure at this time is the diastolic pressure. Also called low pressure, this contraction and relaxation produces the carotid cough sounds when the air bladder pressure is much higher than the systolic pressure. The carotid cough sounds disappear as the air bladder pressure decreases. The carotid cough sounds begin to appear and gradually increase. When the amplitude of the carotid cough sounds reaches its maximum, the air bladder pressure is at the mean pressure, then the carotid cough sounds attenuate as the air bladder pressure decreases. With the maximum amplitude at the mean pressure, you can calculate through specific amplitude hand washing, you can find the amplitudes corresponding to diastolic and systolic pressure. The corresponding net pressure at this time is the systolic and diastolic pressure. There are also some devices that measure during the pressurization process. The measurement ends with rapid deflation. The principle is the same, but the process is reversed. The Watch D2 has a built-in micro air pump. Paired with an ultra-narrow air bladder, it also measures blood pressure using the oscillometric method during the pressurization process. Electronic blood pressure monitors are divided into upper arm and wrist types, but traditional wrist-type blood oximeters are also relatively large. The Watch D2 is equivalent to an ultrasmall wrist-type oscillometric electronic blood pressure monitor, although the non-invasive and fully automatic oscillometric method is the most popular blood pressure measurement method today, but it is necessary to equip the band with an air bladder. The aesthetics and comfort of daily wear will inevitably be compromised. So some watches use another non-invasive air bladder-free method to measure blood pressure by extracting PEGI signal waveform characteristics. Many parameters can be analyzed from the PEG pulse waveform, such as contraction time, maximum point duration, pulsatile pulse time, time to reach the maximum derivative point through multiple regression calculations using blood pressure and these parameter sets. A blood pressure estimation model can be obtained, but the main function of this model is to determine the reasonable range of the proportionality factor. It cannot be directly used for user blood pressure measurement, therefore, before testing blood pressure on watches like the Haman Samsung. It is also necessary to use an oscillometric blood pressure monitor to measure a set of blood pressures for calibration. This calibration process is to use the individual parameters of the user to adjust the proportionality factor. To build a local model that is only suitable for the individual user to maintain the accuracy of the local model, regular calibration is required. To adapt to individual differences and physiological changes, it is still relatively troublesome to use. Next, let's test the accuracy of the Haman eye blood pressure. We referred to this experiment designed according to international general standards. The reference device is the Omron HEME 7361 electronic blood pressure monitor. The test method is after the subject rests quietly for 10 minutes, measure continuously and alternately on the same side of the arm. Each group of measurements uses the blood pressure monitor 6 times. The watch is tested 5 times. Each measurement is spaced more than 60 seconds apart. The test value of the watch is compared with the average value of the reference values of the 2 blood pressure monitors before and after. For comparison, each watch is tested for a total of 4 groups of 20 values, and then data analysis is performed. The average error of the Haman systolic pressure is 0.95 mmHg. The diastolic pressure is 0.025 mmHg. It's still very accurate, which is much smaller than the positive 5 mmHg required by the general standard. The standard deviation of systolic pressure is 4.2 mmHg. The diastolic pressure is 4.30 meg also meets the general standard requirement that the standard deviation is less than 8 mm edge. The error distribution of the entire scatter plot is also relatively uniform. Let's look at the Hammond balance that uses PG measurement. The average error of systolic pressure is 0.55 mm meg. The standard deviation is 5.96 mm meg, also meets the requirements of the general standard. But the standard deviation is slightly larger. The scatter plot also shows Hammond has a kind of regular trend overestimating low blood pressure and underestimating high blood pressure. A blood pressure of 120 is 13 mmHg lower. The systolic performance is okay. The average error is 0.85 mmHg. The standard deviation is 2.9 mmHg. Due to the small number of subjects, the results we measured, there is no significant difference between PAPI and the oscillometric method. But the large number of documents we have read show that the accuracy of PG measurement of blood pressure is currently still difficult to be satisfactory. The oscillometric method is still a more mature and stable solution. It is also more convenient to use Huawei with the oscillometric method. You can measure anytime, anywhere. Hami, Samsung must first prepare a blood pressure monitor for baseline calibration. The measurement is also limited to the same side of the arm of the calibrator. It is impossible to measure for friends with your own watch. If you have the need for a watch to measure blood pressure, it is still more recommended to use a watch with the oscillometric method. Although the Huawei Qi mainly focuses on blood pressure function on the PEG sensor, it also uses the same mysterious perception system as the Huawei GT5. Although the mysterious system has added a blood oxygen light group with spaced arrangement, but the heart rate light is still centered and surrounded by 6 PDs. Equivalent to a surrounding sensor, but this heart rate light group configuration has already had very good performance on the GT5 series. The absolute error of the heart rate screen is far superior to a number of watches with needle type heart rate light groups. Our heart rate test will involve wearing the watch for 3 exercises, namely elliptical outdoor running and strength training. After wearing the watch on the left hand for 20 minutes of exercise, switch to the right hand, the tightness of the watch will seriously affect the test results. So we must strictly control the tightness of each watch. Wearing it too loosely will cause it to slide easily. Wearing it too tightly will constrict the wrist. Affecting blood circulation are wearing standard. During exercise, the watch is worn about 1 centimeter above the wrist bone. Worn a bit tighter than usual with the help of the other hand's movement, there is no direct displacement between the watch and the skin. Instead, the watch drives the skin to move together. Finally, the real-time heart rate data obtained is matched and aligned second by second with the Pola real-time heart rate belt. Then the mean absolute error is calculated. Huawei's second heart rate performance is still quite excellent. The average absolute error for running is 0.91. Still in second place, the heart rate curve can be said to be a perfect fit. The elliptical machine is slightly worse with an average absolute error of 1.31. The heart rate curve fit is also not bad without a large deviation. The average absolute error for strength training is 130. Only here the heart rate drops 10 seconds slower. Other times it can be called perfect. These are the small scatter plots for the 3 exercises. Overall, they are also very close to the red line X equals Y. Without a large deviation, the total average absolute error is 118. Ranking third, if it weren't for the Apple Watch S10 holding it up, the heart rate chart would have been dominated by Xuanji. Moving on to blood oxygen testing under normal circumstances, a person's blood oxygen level hovers around 98%. The error between different watches will be particularly small. Therefore, we must lower the tester's blood oxygen to test how accurate the watch's blood oxygen is. For this purpose, we purchased a hypoxia machine. Commonly known as a high-altitude simulator, it can filter out oxygen through molecular sieves to simulate the atmosphere at an altitude of 6,500 meters. We chose to simulate the atmosphere at an altitude of 4,500 meters to test the watch's blood oxygen monitoring capabilities, switching between the left and right hands every 5 minutes and adjusting the position to avoid the measurement point falling on areas with more veins and capillaries, thereby affecting the test results. Each watch was tested for a total of 20 minutes. Finally, it was compared with a transmissive fingertip pulse oximeter, and the average error was calculated. In previous tests, we discovered a bug in the GT5 Pro's blood oxygen algorithm and reported it to Huawei Wearables. And they quickly fixed the bug, then pushed a test package for us to test, and now the algorithm has been updated in the official version. After actual testing, Huawei's second blood oxygen average error is 0.83, and Apple is the only other brand with a blood oxygen average error below 1. Thus, Xuanji's sensing system has become a dominant force in both heart rate and blood oxygen. Its strength is very powerful. Next is sleep. Here we use data from the Muse S second generation headband as the standard data source. This is an 11-channel EEG monitoring device. It has 7 electrodes and also has PEG sensors to assist in measuring heart rate. It can be used to monitor breathing and the gyroscope for body movement. Its accuracy for sleep stages is between about 88% and 96%, is the most accurate personal sleep monitoring device we can currently find. Every night, the tester wears the Muse headband and wears a watch on each wrist for sleep, switching left and right hands every day. Each watch is tested for more than 4 days at the same time. A monitor with night vision function is used for full monitoring. The sleep analysis data obtained from the Muse headband is verified using the monitoring video to remove any possible misjudged data. A 3-minute clear time is kept before and after sleep, but the final result is used as the standard and compared minute by minute with the sleep analysis data obtained from the watch. Then data analysis is performed to obtain the final result. This is the confusion matrix of the sleep analysis consistency rate of Huawei's second watch. If any friends don't understand it, you can go to our mini program and website for this sleep ranking and then click on the question mark to view the explanation of the confusion matrix. The overall consistency rate of Huawei's second sleep analysis is 46.8%. Among the 4 sleep stages, the worst performance is REM 7. With only 18.9%, the second watch attributes most of the REM 7 time to light sleep. The other stages are still acceptable from the duration of the 4 stages. Huawei severely underestimates the duration of REM and overestimates the duration of deep sleep. Muse judges the duration of REM to be 417 minutes. The second watch is 207 minutes, less than half the time. Muse judges the duration of deep sleep to be only 163 minutes. The second watch is 345 minutes. More than double the estimate the sleep results of Huawei Watch 2nd are still at Huawei's consistent level currently. All Huawei watches we have tested do not have much difference. The sleep consistency rate between 40% and 50%, which is relatively poor in the GPS test. We chose a regular urban route in Guoming District, Shenzhen. The tester wore the watch and started the walking mode using a measuring wheel. They walked a total of 3,000 meters finally, based on the distance obtained by the watch. The error per kilometer is calculated. The error per kilometer of Huawei Watch 2nd is 33.3 meters per kilometer, ranking 13th in the list. Not very excellent, but after all, it is a watch that focuses on health monitoring rather than a sports watch, and it is already better than the encrypted 25. This result is not bad. Huawei Watch 2nd belongs to the large power consumption category with raise it awake screen on always in display, and all health monitoring functions except dynamic blood pressure measurement turned on. The actual battery life is 6.5 days. This result is still very excellent in terms of charging. The charging time of Huawei Watch 2nd is 1 hour and 55 minutes, from depleted to full is 2 hours and 52 minutes. This charging speed is a bit slow, almost 1 hour slower than the GD5 Pro in terms of storage configuration. It only has 4G. Consistent with the Huawei Watch G5 series in terms of body materials, watch face, aluminum alloy body, plastic back cover. The same configuration as the Xiaomi Watch SD4, but the Xiaomi only costs $9,999. Huawei is nearly $3,000 at least. It should have a sapphire watch face. The body size is 4 x 30 mm, not very large, a bit smaller than the Apple Watch 4 Pro. Huawei down 3,000 Zhixin 3.1 x 38 mm, Vivo Watch 4 Pro Xiao Xiaomi. But the actual measured center thickness reached 15.3 mm. It's still a bit thick after all. The built-in air pump also takes up some space. So it's understandable, and Huawei watches have always been quite thick in terms of appearance. The sides of the case have a sandblasted finish. The front has a polished finish at first glance. The appearance is okay. It's much more beautiful than the previous generation. But if you look closely at the polished front, you can see some spots. It's very obvious when magnified with a macro lens. The surface is still a bit rough. Here we compare it with the polishing on the Xiaomi Watch S4. Xiaomi's gloss is higher and the surface looks very smooth and flat when magnified. Xiaomi uses a physical vapor deposition film. We speculate that Huawei uses anodic oxidation polishing. The flatness will be slightly worse. This is also why the texture of aluminum alloy bright frames on Android phones has always been far inferior to Apple's. The Dawn Gold strap is made of composite material. The front is made of leather and the back is made of rubber, combining the elegance of leather and the durability of rubber. Plus, the gold folding buckle makes the entire strap very textured. If you change to a black strap, both sides are made of floating rubber. It's more ordinary. The air bladder of this strap cannot be removed, which is a pity. If you need a strap without an air bladder, you have to pay extra to buy it. In terms of screen brightness, the peak brightness of YO's second can actually reach 1650 nits, which is still very good. It has already exceeded its own GD5 Pro and is close to the Apple Watch S9 in terms of West-level brightness. Huawei's strategy is very aggressive in strong light. YO's second is brighter than Apple S10 in terms of the system, the protocol notification function designed for round watches. Did not appear on the second as expected, and the GT5 Pro can directly switch the application layout at the top of the application menu. But the second cannot. It also lacks the emotional health function of the GT5 Pro, but the hardware of the second can fully support it, which is still a pity in terms of watch faces. The official free watch faces of YO second are fewer than the GT5 Pro. Some watch faces that are repeated with the GT5 Pro have also been adapted for the second, but many third-party watch faces are directly cut down from the GT5 Pro's watch faces. For example, this Chinese-style oil dragon Black Mirror watch face the designer did not adapt the second hand in order to be lazy and simply and rudely cut the pointer and animation, which much cheaper. The few new square watch faces of the second, such as the Elegant Light, look a bit too similar to Apple's watch faces. As for the effect, we will not comment. You can see the comparison yourself. YO's second is equipped with a mysterious system with accurate blood pressure monitoring, heart rate monitoring, blood oxygen monitoring, and excellent battery life. As just an ordinary smartwatch, it is also considered relatively excellent, but the screen cover, the case and back cover materials are one level worse than the GT5 Pro, and 9088 is still a bit expensive if you are a user who does not need blood pressure measurement. It is still more recommended to get the GT5 Pro if you really have the need to measure blood pressure anytime and anywhere. Then the accuracy and ease of use of the second are still far superior to Samsung and Huawei, this kind of blood pressure measurement function based on PPG signals. In fact, besides Huawei, Xiaomi has also released a trial blood pressure watch, the Xiaomi Watch S71. Now, regardless of the accuracy of the A71's blood pressure monitoring, this blood pressure watch uses the same PG sensor as the Xiaomi Watch SS2, which is two generations behind Huawei. But from this point, there is no way to recommend it to everyone for your viewing.